Okay. So good morning. We'll start in the last class. We have left with the revision of the first syllabus for your internals. We'll continue with that today. Okay. So till here. Last class I have done. Okay. Who are cyber criminals? Criminals are those who conduct activities such as child pornography, credit card fraud, cyber talk, defaming other online, gaining unauthorized access to the computer system, ignoring copyright, software licensing and trademark protection, overriding encryption to make illegal copies, software piracy, and stealing another identity to perform criminal acts. Type 1, cyber criminals, hungry for recognition. Type 2, cyber criminals, not interested in recognition. Type 3, cyber criminals, the insider, maybe some within the company. So the classification of cybercrime in the broad and narrow way. So the role of the computer as an object, the computer or information stored on the computer is a subject or a target of the crime. Example, hacking, computer sabotage, distributed denial of service attack, virtual child pornography. So then in a broader sense, these are in a narrow sense. So in the broader sense, so computer as a tool, the computer and or information stored on the computer constitutes an important tool for committing the crime, computer fraud, forgery, distribution of child pornography. So then computer as an environment or the context, the computer information stored on the computer plays a substantial okay 8, 9, 10 is your internals, right? The computer information stored on the computer plays a non-substantial role in the act of crime but does not contain evidence of crime, murder using computer technique, bank robbery and drug trade. Cybercrime are classified as follows: cybercrime against individual, cybercrime against property, cybercrime against organization, cybercrime against society, cyber crimes emanating from Usenet news group. So email spoofing, a spoofed email is one that appears to originate from one resource, from one source, but actually has been sent from another source. What is spamming? People who create electronic spam are called as a spammer. So what is spammer? The people who create spam are called spammer. A spam is the abuse of electronic message system to send unsolicited bulk message indiscriminately. And spamming is wisely detested and has been subject of legislation in many judiciary. For example, the CAN Spam Act of 2003. Okay, next, search engine spamming. So spamming is an alternate or creation of a document with the intent to devise an electronic catalog or a filing system. Some web authors use subversion techniques to ensure that their site appears more frequently or higher number in returned search result. Cyber defamation occurs when defamation takes place with the help of computer and or the according to the IPC section 499. It may amount to defamation to impute anything to deceased person if the imputation would harm the reputation of that person if living and is intended to be hurtful to the feeling of his family or other near relatives, it may amount to defamation to take place an imputation concerning a company or an association or collection of such person, collection of persons as such. An imputation is a form of an alternative or expressed ironically may amount to defamation. No imputation is said to harm a person's reputation unless that imputation directly or indirectly in the estimation of others lower the moral or intellectual character of that person, lower the character of that person in respect of his caste or of his calling, or lower the credit of that person, or causing it to be believed that the body of the of that person is in the loathsome state or in the state generally considered as a disagreeable. The law on defamation attempts to create a workable balance between two equal important human rights, the right to an unimpaired reputation, the right to freedom or freedom of expression. Internet time theft occurs when an unauthorized person uses the internet hours paid for by another person. It comes under hacking because the person gets access to someone else's ISP's user ID and password, either by hacking or by gaining access to it by an illegal mean. Then Salmi attack or Salmi technique. These techniques are used for committing financial crimes. No account holder will probably notice this unauthorized debit, but the bank employee will make a seizable amount every month. Data diggling attack involves alternate raw data just before it is processed by the computer and then changing it back after the processing is completed. Electricity board in India has been a victim to data diggling program inserted when private parties computerize their system. Forging counterfeit currency notes, postage and revenue stamps, mark sheets, etc., using sophisticated computers, printers and scanners. Webjacking occurs when someone forcefully takes control on a website by cracking the password and later changing it. News group or a spam or crimes emanating from Usenet news group. The advent of Google Group and its large Usenet archives has made Usenet more attractive to spammers than ever. Spamming of Usenet news groups actually predates email spam. Industrial spamming and industrial espionage. Spies can get information about product finances, research and development, and marketing strategies, an activity known as industrial spamming. Target attacks. Target attack plays very well to organize that are victims of focused attacks aiming at stealing corporate data, intellectual property, or whatever else that may yield a competitive advantage for a viral company. There are two distinct business models for cybercrime applied to industrial spying: selling torchonware, selling stolen intellectual properties. Hacking. Hackers, crackers, and frackers are some of the often heard terms. The original meaning of the word hack means an elegant, witty, or inspired way of doing almost anything organized at the MIT. Hackers write or use ready-made computer programs to attack the target computer. They possess the desire to destruct and they get enjoyment out of such destruction. Some hackers hack for personal monetary gains, such as stealing credit card information, transferring money from various bank accounts to their own account allowed by withdrawal of money. Online fraud, types of crimes under the category of hacking, spoofing website and email security alerts, hoax mail about virus threats, lottery frauds and spoofing. Spoofing websites and email security threats. Frauders create authentic looking websites that are actually nothing but a spoof. The purpose of these websites is to make the user enter personal information, which is then used to access business and bank accounts. This kind of online fraud is common to banking and financial sector. It is strongly recommended not to input and sensitive information that might help criminals to gain access to sensitive information such as bank account details, even if the page appears legitimate. So virus hoax emails, the warning may be genuine. So there is always a dilemma whether to take them lightly or seriously. A wise action is to first confirm by visiting an antivirus site such as McAfee, Sophia or Systematic before taking any action, such as forwarding them to friends and colleagues. Lottery fraud, typical letter or emails that inform the recipient that he or she was won a prize in a lottery. To get the money, the recipient has to replay, after which another mail is receiving asking for bank details so that the money can be directly transferred. Spoofing, a hacker log in into a computer illegally using a different identity that has his own. He creates a new identity by fooling the computer into thinking that the hacker is a genuine system operator, and then hackers that takes control of the system. Then pornographic offense, a child pornography include any photography that can be considered obscene and or unsuitable for the child, for the age of the child to view, either it may be film or video or pictures. Computer generated image or picture or of sexual exploit conduct where the production of such visual depiction involves the use of minor engaging in sexual explicit conduct. As a broadband connection, get into the reach of more and more homes, children, larger child population will be using the internet, and therefore greater would be the chance of falling victims to the aggressive of the pedophilias. So software privacy, the theft of software through the illegal copy of genuine programs or the counterfeiting and distribution of products instead of pass for the original. Thus, who buy pirated software have a lot of loose getting untested software that may have been copied thousands of times over. The software pirated may potentially contain hard drive infecting viruses. There is no technical support in the case of software failure, that is lack of technical product support available to a properly licensed users. There is no warranty protection. There is no legal right to use the product. Economic impact of software piracy is grievances. So we can see here how the software piracies dollars lost in the year 2008 due to software piracy. Regional scenario, globally 2008, in the year 2008, piracy study released on May 2009 at the following link. So in Asia specific, so how much was the in 2008, they have just made a comparison between 2008 and 2007 software piracies. So if we take about Asian specific, so much dollars, that is 15,261 dollars in 2008 in the areas Asia specific. So in 2007, 14,090 dollars for the same location that is Asia specific. So in the same way, Central or Eastern Europe, $7,003 for 2008. In the same way, $6,351 for the year 2007. So Latin America, again, $4,311. In the same, that was for the year 2008. So similarly for 2007 also, $4,123. In the same area, Latin America. In the same way, Middle East and Africa, the dollars was 2,999 in the year 2008. And in 2007, dollars 2,446. North America, $10,401. And 9,144. Then Western Europe, dollars 13023. So then dollars 11655. European Union, 2008, 13981. 12383. That was a European Union in 2008 and 2007. In the same way, worldwide, 52998 or 47809. So this was a comparison between the year 2008 and 2007 about software piracies in the different places. So in the same way, computer sabotage, it is the use of internet to hinder the normal functioning of the computers through the introduction of worms, either it may be worms or viruses or logic bombs. It can be used to gain economic advantage over a competitor to promote the illegal activities of terrorists, or to steal data or programs from extorting purposes. Logic bombing are even dependent programs created to do something only when a certain event known as trigger event occurs. Some viruses may be termed as a logic bombing. Email bombing or mail bombing, it refers to sending a large number of email to the victim to crash victims email account or to make victim's mail server crash in the case of company or an email service provider. Computer program can be written to instruct a computer to do such tasks on a repeated basis. Usenet news group as the source of cyber crimes. Usenet is a popular means of sharing and distributing information on the web with respect to specific topic or a subject. It is a mechanism that allows sharing information in a many-to-many manner. The news groups are spread across 30,000 different topics. Computer network intrusions. Computer network pose a problem by way of security threats because people can get into them from anywhere. The cracker can bypass existing password protection by creating a program to capture logon IDs and passwords. The practice of strong password is therefore important. Password sniffing. Password sniffer are programs that monitor and record the name and password of network users as they log in geopolitically security at a site. Whoever installs the sniffer can then impersonate an unauthorized user and log in to access restricted documents. Credit card frauds. Billions of dollars may be lost annually by consumers who have credit card and calling card number stolen from online database. Bulletin board and other online service are frequent target for hackers who want to access large database of credit card information. Then identity theft. Identity theft is a fraud involving another person's identity for an illicit purpose. This occurs when a criminal uses someone else's identity for his or her own illegal purpose. The cyber impersonate can steal unlimited funds in the victim's name without the victim even knowing about it for a month, sometimes even for the year. Cybercrime, the legal perspective. कंप्यूटर साइबर क्राइम क्रिमिनल जस्टिस रिसोर्स मैनुअल द कंप्यूटर कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर क्राइम कंप्यूटर रिलेटेड क्राइम वॉज डिफाइंड इन द बॉर्डर मीनिंग एज any legal act for which knowledge of computer technology is essential for a successful protection then cybercrime outcome of a globalized information system accommodate an increasing number of transnational offenses this problem can be resolved in two ways divide information system into segments broader by state boundaries incorporate the legal system into an integrated entity obliterating these state boundaries cybercrime an indian perspective india has a fourth highest number of internet user in the world there are 45 million internet users in india 37% from cyber cafes 57% of users are between 18 to 35 years a point to note is that the majority of offenders were under 30 years and about 46 cyber crimes cases were related to incidents of cyber pornography and in over 60% of these cases offenders were between 18 and 30 years cyber crime and the Indian ITA 2000 the first step towards the law relating to e-commerce at international level to regulate an alternative form of commerce and to give legal status in the area of e-commerce hacking and the Indian law cyber crime are punishable under two categories in ITA 2000 and IPC the total of 207 cases of cyber crime were registered under the IT Act in 2007 compared to 142 cases registered in 2006 under the IPC 2339 cases were recorded in 2007 compared to 311 cases in 2006 a global perspective on cyber criminals in Australia cybercrime has a narrow statutory meaning as used in a cybercrime act 2001 which deals offenses against computer data and system in the council of europe cybercrime trendy cybercrime is used as an umbrella term to refer to an array of criminal activity including offenses against computer data and system computer related offenses content offenses and copyright offenses recently there have been a number of significant developments such as August 4, 2006 announcement. The US Senate rectifies Convention of Cybercrime. In August 18, 2006, there was a new article published. ISPs worry about drastic obligation on website blocking. Cybercrime Conventions 1997 and 2001 was the first international treaty seeking to address internet crimes by harmonizing national laws, improvising investigating techniques, and increasing cooperation among nations. Cybercrime and the extended enterprises. It is the responsibility of each user to become aware of threats as well as the opportunities that connectivity and mobility presents them with extended enterprise represents the concepts that a company is made up not just as just of its employee its broad member and executives but also its business partner its supplier and even its customer so here we can see the virtual integration strategic alliance core competency outsourcing customer partnership so here cybercrime era a survival mantra for the netizens so netizens is someone who spends considerable time online and also has considerable presence online through websites about the person through his or her active blog contribution and or also his or her participation in the online chat room. The 5P netizen mantra for online security is precaution, prevention, protection, preservation, and preservance. For ensuring cyber safety, the motto for the netizen should be stranger in is danger. Cyber offenses, how criminals plan them. So in today's world of internet and computer network, cyber activity can be carried out across national border with false sense of anatomy. So attacker could look to exploit the vulnerability in the network, such as inadequate border protection, border as in the sense of network periphery, remote access server, RASS, with weak access control, application server with well-known exploits, misconfigured systems and systems with default configuration. A category of cybercrime. Cybercrime can be categorized based on the following: the target of crime and whether the crime occurs as a single event or a series of events. The target of crime, crimes targets at individual, crime targets at property, crimes target at organization, single event of cybercrime, series of events. How cyber criminals plan the attack? Reconnaissance means what? Information gathering. Reconnaissance information gathering is the first phase or a first part, and it treats as a passive attack. Scanning and scrutinizing the gathered information for the validity of the information, as well as to identify and existing vulnerability. Launching an attack, gaining and maintaining the system access. Reconnaissance is an act of reconnecting, exploring, often with the goal of finding something or somebody, especially to gain information about an enemy or potential enemy. Reconnaissance begins with footprinting. This is the preparation towards pre-attack phase. Involve accumulating data about the target environment with computer architecture to find ways to introduce into that environment. Passive attack. A passive attack involves gathering information about a target without his or her individual's or company's knowledge. It is usually done using internet search or by Googling an individual or a company to gain information. Active attack. An active attack involves probing the network to discover individual host to confirm the information gathering in the passive attack phase. It involves the risk of detection and is also called rattling the doorknobs or active reconnaissance. Active reconnaissance can provide information to an attacker about security measures in place. Scanning and scrutinizing gathered information. The objective of scanning are port scanning, network scanning, vulnerability scanning. Port scanning identify open and closed ports and services. Network scanning, understand IP address and related information about network system. Vulnerability scanning, understand the existing weakness in the system. Attack, gain and maintain the system access. After the scanning and enumeration, the attack is launched using the following steps: crack the password, exploit the privilege, execute the malicious commands and application, hide the files if required, cover the attack or delete the access logs so that there is no trial illicit activity. Social engineering, it is a technique to influence or persuasion to deceive people to obtain the information or perform some action. Social engineering exploits the natural tendency of a person to trust social engineering's word rather than exploiting computer security holes. Social engineering involves gaining sensitive information or unauthorized access privilege by building inappropriate trust relationship with insider. The sign of truly successful social engineer is that they receive information without any suspension. Classification of social engineering: human-based social engineering, computer-based social engineering. Human-based social engineering refers to person-to-person interaction to get the required desired information. Computer-based social engineering refers to an attempt made to get the required or desired information by using a computer software or internet. Cyber talks, it is defined as the use of information and communication technology, particularly the internet, by an individual or a group of individuals to harass another individual, group of individuals or organization. Cyber talks refers to the use of internet and or other electronic communication device to stalk another person. It involves harassing or threatening behavior that an individual will conduct repeatedly. As the internet has become an integral part of our personal and professional lives, cyber talkers take advantage of ease of communication and an increased access to personal information available with the few mouse click or keystrokes. Type of stalkers. There are primarily two types of stalkers as listed below. Online stalkers, the aim to start the interaction with the victim directly with the help of internet. Offline stalkers, the stalker may begin with attack using traditional methods such as following the victim, watching the daily routine of the victim, etc. How stalks work: personal information gathering about the victim, establishing a contact with victim through telephone or cell phone. Once the contact is established, the stalker may make calls to the victim to threaten or harass. Stalkers will almost always establish a contact with the victim through email. The stalker may use multiple names while contacting the victims. Some stalkers keep on sending repeated emails asking for various kinds of favor or threaten the victim. The stalker may post the victim's personal information on any website relating to illicit service such as sex worker services or dating services, posing as if the victim has posted the information, and invite the people to call the victim on the given contact details. The stalker will use a bad or a offensive, attractive language to invite the interested persons. Those whosoever comes across the information start calling the victim on the given contact details, asking for sexual service or relationship. Some stalkers subscribe or register the email account of the victim to innumerable pornographic and sex sites, because of which victims will start receiving such kind of unsolicited email. Cybercafe and cybercrimes such as stealing of bank passwords and subsequent fraudulent withdrawal of money have also happened through cybercafes. Cybercafes have also been used regularly for sending obscene mails to harass people. Indian Information Act, ITA 2000, interprets cybercafes as network service provider referred to under the Ernest Wilde Section 79, which imposes on them a responsibility for due diligence, failing which they would be liable for the offenses committed in their network. So one example for cyber security. So ICICI Bank, so this is one where you can see cyber cafe security. If you are accessing any website from web cyber cafe, any shared computer or from a computer, often computer other than that of your own, please change your password after such use from your own PC at workplace or at a home. It is very important to do so, especially when you have entered your transaction password from such shared computer or cyber cafe computer. change these passwords from your own PCs at workplace or at house, or virtual keyboards for the internet banking. At ICICI Bank, we are committed to make your banking with use of safe and wonderful experience. We provide you with the virtual keyboard to protect your password. Virtual keyboard is an online application to enter passwords with the help of a mouse. So why do we require, or what is the advantage of using a virtual keyboard? The virtual keyboard is designed to protect your password from malicious spywares and torsion programs. Use of virtual keyboard will reduce the risk of password theft. Process to use virtual keyboard. Steps to use virtual keyboard are as follows. Enter login ID using physical keyboard. Select the checkbox. Use virtual keyboards. Use a virtual keyboard to the login password. Once you have entered your password, click login. The functions on different keys on the virtual keyboard, caps lock on. This key can be used to enter uppercase if the password consists of capital letters. Backspace, this key will clear the last character entered in the password field. Clear, this key will clear all characters entered in the password field by virtual keyboard. This key is visible only for change or forced change password field by virtual keyboard. This key can be used to enter value in the next field. Cyber criminals can either install malicious programs such as keylogger and or spyware, or launch an attack on the target. Here are a few tips for safety and security while using the computer in a cyber cafe. Always log out. Stay with the computer. Clear history and temporary files. Be alert. Avoid online financial transaction. Change password, virtual keyboard, security warning. Botnet, the fuel for cybercrime. A botnet, also called as zombie network, is a network of computer infected with malicious programs that allows cyber criminals to control the infected machine remotely without the user knowledge. Your computer system may be a part of botnet even though it appears to be operating normally. Botnets are often used to conduct a range of activities, from distributing spam and viruses to conduct denial of service attacks. One of ensuring following to secure system, use antivirus and anti-spyware software and keep it up to date. Set the operating system to download and install security patches automatically. Use a firewall to protect the system from hacking attacks while it is connected on the internet. Disconnect from the internet when you are away from your computer. Download the freeware only when websites that are known and trustworthy. Check regularly the folder in the mailbox. Sent items or outgoing. For those messages you did not send, take an immense action if your system is infected. Attack vector. An attack vector is a path or means by which an attacker can gain access to a computer or to a network server to deliver a payload or malicious outcomes. Attacker include viruses, email attachments, web pages, pop-up windows, install messages, chat rooms, and deception. The most common malicious payload are viruses, torsion horses, worms, and spyware. If an attack vector is thought of as a guided missile, its payload can be compared to the warhead in the tip of the missile. Payload means the malicious activity that the attack performs. It is a bit that get delivered to the end user at the destination. The attack vector described here are how most of them are launched. Attack by email, attachment, and other files. Attack by deception, hackers, headless gestures, attack by the web page, attack of the worms, malicious macros, hostware, sneakware, viruses. And what is cloud computing? A cloud computing service will offer while offering considerable benefits and cost saving, it makes easier for a cyber criminal to attack themselves. Cloud computing is internet-based development and use of computer technology. A cloud service has three distinct characteristics which differentiate it from a traditional hosting. It is a solid on-demand. It is elastic in terms of usage. This service is fully managed by the provider. Advantage of cloud computing. Cloud computing has following advantage. Applications and data can be accessed from anywhere at any time. It could bring hardware cost down. Organizations do not have to buy a set of software or software licenses for every employee, and the organization could pay a meter fee to cloud computing company. Organizations do not have to rent a physical space to store servers and databases. Servers and digital storage devices take up space. Organization could be able to save money on IT support because organization will have to ensure about the desktop and continue internet connectivity instead of server and other hardware. The cloud computing service can be either private or public. Public cloud sells a service to anyone of the internet. Private cloud, like a proprietary network or a data center that supplies the host service to a limited number of people. Types of services, the services services provided by the cloud computing are as follows: infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, software as a service. So this is what the services are provided by different service providers. One is Amazon. It offers flexible, simple, and easy computing environment in the cloud that allows development of application. Then 3 Tera, it offers AppLogic grid operating system that enables infrastructure solutions according to the changing needs of the business. Force.com, it allows building of core business applications like enterprise resource planning, human resource management, and supply chain management. Then AppTrait, cloud computing middleware, it allows easily scalable cloud computing for a wide variety of applications and service for both public and private cloud. Microsoft Live Mesh, this cloud setup synchronizes the files with the all users' device like laptop, Mac, mobile phone, or other, and allows to access the files from any device as well as enable sharing of files. AppNext, this helps user to launch several operating systems, run a variety of application, load balance these applications, and store huge amount of secure data. FlexiScale, it is self-service through control panel or API, features full self-service, start, stop, delete, change memory, CPU storage, IPs of virtual dedicated servers. Google App Engine, this is a free setup that allows the user to run their web application on Google infrastructure. GoGrid, it offers unique multi-server control panel that enables the user to deploy and manage load-balanced cloud server. TerraMark Enterprise Cloud, it provides the power to the user for computing resources for users, million critical applications. Cybercrime and cloud computing. Prime area of the risk in cloud computing is protection of user data. Table 2 shows the major areas of concern in cloud computing domain. Elevated user access. What is the risk? How to remediate the risk? Any data processed outside the organization brings with it an inherent level of risk, as outsourced service may bypass the physical, logical, and personal control and will have elevated user access to data. Regulatory compliance, cloud computing service provider are not able or not willing to undergo external assessments. This can result into non-compliance with various standards laws like the US government, health insurance portability and accountability. location of data, the organization that are obtaining cloud computing services may be aware about the data is hosted and may not even know in which country is hosted. Same way, segregation of data, recovery of data, information security violation report, long-term viability. So I'll stop here and do well for your internals.